Wishing I was deep in the water somewhere. Got the blue sky breeze and it don't seem fair. Only worry in the world is the tide gonna reach my chair. Wouldn't that be great? The tide to reach our chair. Today we're taking a look at tides, and in particular we're going to take a look at different tidal patterns. This particular diagram is right in your textbook. As you can see, it shows North America and part of South America, and the different type of tides found at different locations along the coastlines. It also gives you the tidal range in meters. Let's take a look at these different tidal patterns. The first type of tidal pattern we're going to take a look at is the diurnal pattern. Diurnal, di, ultimately meaning two, so in other words, they have a low tide and a high tide in one 24-hour and 50-minute period. You can see that the diurnal tidal pattern is pretty much exclusive right along the Gulf of Mexico and parts of Alabama. A second type of tide is your semi-diurnal tidal pattern, or basically half of the diurnal pattern. So you have a high tide and a low tide in 12 hours, and then another high tide and another low tide. So you have two high tides and two low tides in a 24-hour and 50-minute period. You see that the East Coast has this type of tidal pattern. Now let's go back and take a look at what we have on our own west coast. Ultimately, it is a type of a semi-diurnal pattern. It is called a mixed tidal pattern. And within 24 hours, we again have four tides. You've got two low tides, and you've got two high tides. The high tides, you have a lower high tide, and you have a higher high tide. And of your two low tides, you have a low low tide, and you have a high-low tide. You can see along the coast, along the west coast, that there are different tidal ranges, and that is a question that we will take a look at in class.